won the first two sets. They're up 2-0.
Excellent.
They're back in action on Friday.
Yep.
Football's in action on Saturday. They got senior day. So some big news coming from the football team as well. Did you hear about that?
About the game against Mayville State for next week is going to be at the Fargo Dome.
How cool is that?
That is good. Now I know the Vikings have played there before when they played against Concordia College. They have played some games at the Fargo Dome, but that'll be neat playing in the Dome.
Yeah, no, that's a very unique experience. A lot of people don't really get to experience.
Exactly.
So that's pretty cool. Pretty happy for those guys.
Have you been there?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
Yep. A couple NDSU games and a couple just other events.
Cool. Well, the ball's tipped in the air, and we'll get underway here. The Vikings won the tip. Caden Rickert swings up, stop, top of the key to Owens. Owens in the lane, turns around, right hand, rolls it up, and good.
Nice drive there by Owens.
Here's that press that the Vikings love, Brady. Pass into the front court, far side. Dak hounded there on the far side by Eddie Oyette. Now he gets it back up top to Munson. Out of San Diego, California. A freshman. I want to see him experience his first winter in Minnesota.
Yeah, yeah.
Here in the near side, Johnson gets it down low. Dribble drive, Carlin. Skips back up top. Munson, three-pointer from there. Rolls off, can't get it to fall. Rebound is controlled underneath by the Cougars. And back up, can't get the fall. And we've got a foul underneath as Carlin get the putback. That's going to go against Devontae. Talk about athlete, Devontae Munson. He is a great athlete. Watching him glide up and on the floor.
Yeah, I mean, looking at our starting lineup, you know, other than maybe Owens, a lot of these guys are so tall and they all play guard. They're just so athletic and so big that it makes it tough for teams to even get the ball up the court, especially against this press.
First free throw misfires. Carlin's second one is good. 3-2-1. Vikings early advantage, 49 seconds in. Caden Rickert out of Fargo North High School comes across the timeline. Right hand hit by dribble, far side. Front of the student section, out of the free throw line, hesitates, step back, 15-footer, comes up short. Carlin has the rebound, a foul from behind on Owen.
Yeah, that foul right there, it's just one of those hustle plays that it's really hard to prevent. You're going so hard after the rebound, and it's just one of those things that just happens.
Carlin had that positioning, and it's tough to get the ball when the other guy's got that kind of position. Now the Cougars will bring the ball back up the floor, trailing 2-1. Up top of the key to Dak, here to the near side, dribble drive. Paul Dak, cross-court pass, Munson, three-pointer from the left wing, good.
And I got a feeling that the California native can shoot the basketball.
And probably likes the three. 3-2, early, 4-2, early advantage here for the Cougars. 90 seconds gone, first half, three-pointer, Rickert, good. Anything you can do, I can do too.
Yeah. Anytime you can answer with a three of your own, great feeling.
We have a violation on the baseline as Corbin Alexander crossed over the end line and so turns the ball over. It'll be Viking ball. A 5-4 lead for VCSU, 18-23 to go here first half. Here goes Gotch going in the one-handed jam. Duke Gotch off the inbounds and flushes her down with one hand.
Yeah, I saw Duth Gotch kind of roll around the top of the key and start cutting, and I thought, oh, this is going to be a big slam.
Three-pointer by Alexander misfires, and a rebound taken down by Gotch back into the front court, right-hand dribble. Stop of the key, onto the wing to Rickert. Watch there by Munson, man-to-man defense by the Cougars. Far side to Munson. We got Munson and Munson. Three-pointer by Gotch comes up short, and a rebound taken down by Corbin Alexander for the Cougars. Across the timeline, Alexander, right-hand dribble, picks it up, gets it up top to Munson. Now to the far corner, Johnson. Johnson, free throw line. Alexander thought about it, doesn't shoot. Back to Johnson, dribble drive, left of the lane, back into the near corner. From Dak is Alexander. Inside to Carlin, his little baby hook can't go. Rebound taken down by the Vikings. And Gotch back into the front court to Munson. And he stepped out of bounds.
I think the Cougars are finding out here early on just how big this Viking team is. And, you know, I honestly think they're bigger than last year's
game. Yeah. Sub coming in for the Cougars. Tarek Iob out of Minneapolis, a sophomore, checks in. And looks like the same five on the floor for VCSU. Iob has it, comes across the timeline, top of the key to Carlin. He gives it back to Munson. Munson, looks like the Cougars have slipped into the Vikings have slipped into a zone. Johnson tried to force it, ball was tipped. But re-grabbed by Dak here in the near corner. Here comes Paul Dak into the lane. Kicks it back up top. Munson for three. Off the back iron. Long rebound. Dak has it for the Cougars. Goes back up. Off the glass. Rolls it in. Offensive rebounds can be a killer.
Yeah, those second chance points are really what will kill you in games like these.
7-6. Cougars down by one. Vikings with the basketball in the front court. Far side Munson. Now to Rickert. To Owens. Just off the left elbow. Big watch there by Carlin. Shimmy and shakes. Goes up. Double pump, goes up, and a foul going to be called on Carlin.
They called that one on the floor?
They called it on the floor before the shot. So Carlin will pick up his first team foul. So the inbounds will be on the baseline. Checking in for the Cougars is Kenny Placide out of Vero Beach, Florida. Here's Owens for the Vikings. Split the double team, posting up, top of the key. Gotch works his way in, right of the lane. Looking for the cutter, not really there. Pass was knocked down and stolen. Here comes UMM, back the other way with Munson. Munson, cross court pass, Johnson, back up onto the wing. Iob, inside, and Placide couldn't get his shot off. Loose ball picked up by Munson. Here come the Vikings. Devontae Munson running the court. It's a 3-on-4, he'll take it all the way. Scoop shot good.
Great finish there, through contact. You know, that's kind of one of those 50-50 plays where sometimes it's foul, sometimes it's not, but good job to finish there.
And quickly down the floor was Paul Dak, and his high layup didn't go. Foul going to be called on Owens. That's his second. So Joseph is going to see the bench here momentarily as Lyman will check in at the next opportunity. Yeah, can't get our big man in foul trouble because...
Don't got a lot of them either, is the thing.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's almost like a volleyball rotation with... Lyman and Owens, where they just one comes in, the other comes out, and then it's just vice versa, and they just rotate throughout the game.
Lyman, the kid out of West Fargo, comes in now for VCSU. First free throw is good. 9-7 Cougars, 15-49 or Vikings, 15-49 remaining here in this first half. Second free throw, good. So Paul Dak knocks down a pair, and it's a 1-point lead for VCSU. Caden Rickert, across the logo, pass to Gotch to Rickert, back over to Oyet. Eddie, top of the key, to Gotch, right of the lane. Wants a baseline. Gets it cut off, fade away, ball tipped out of his hands, got it back, then throws it right into the hands of Dak, steal for the Cougars. Dak into the front court to Munson here on the near wing, right in front of the Viking bench, back to Dak, lobs it here near side to Munson, back to Dak in the lane, kicks it onto the far wing, three-pointer by Iob, no, rebound, Rickert.
Coach Montgomery is really showing that they're going to saying, you know, you're going to have to beat us with the three tonight.
And sometimes you live by the three, you're going to die by the three, too. You can't get those offensive rebounds. Here's Oyet, tried to kick it out, was fouled in the process. And Dak will pick up his first.
I mean, you can just tell Valley City really does not want to give them anything in the paint. And, you know, Morris is going to get looks like that tonight.
Cuyava checks into the lineup now for the Cougars. Jarrett Cuyava out of Hallock, Minnesota. Onto the far wing, left wide open, Munson for three off the back iron. And the other Munson for the Cougars clears off the rebound. And the loose ball near side, picked up by UMM. Now Munson on the far side, bounce pass into the corner. Off to Cuyava. Cuyava circles around, top of the key. Picks up the dribble off the right elbow. Back up top to Munson. Solid D here by the Vikings. 10 on the shot clock. Dibble drive. Inside Placide. Gets it off to Munson. In amongst the trees. No. Placide has the rebound. Kicks it up top. And we have a travel. Great defense by the Cougars by the Vikings on that possession.
Yeah, one thing they're doing really well is just in the zone, they're rotating to each man very well, transitioning from guy to guy and making it very tough. You know, even just a pass, they're clogging up the passing lanes very well tonight.
They did get a second shot, but they created the turnover on the travel. Up top, Rickert circling in, through a double team, right hand high off the glass for two by Caden Rickert.
That's a tough finish. That is a very tough finish. Man in his face, and he's able to hit the floater.
Vikings on top, 11-8. Cougars with the basketball, 14 minutes remaining here in the first half. Just off the elbow, left side, Corbin. Alexander goes cross court. The Iob. Now down low was Lyman, and we've got a foul underneath. I think on BCSU.
Yeah, I believe that one's on Lyman. Got him with the pump fake.
That'll be his first. Tate Hebrink in. Hebrink in the season opening victory against Northwestern came off the bench and scored 22 for the Vikings. Had 10 in the next game in the loss to Dort.
Yeah, great shooting performance by him over the weekend. It just seemed like he couldn't miss.
Now is his sister playing in town here for the BCSU women?
Yeah, she didn't play tonight, but I did see that she's playing now, and I've actually got her in a few of my classes.
Okay.
Really nice person, and we like Elise. Happy she's here.
13:43 to go. Cougars inbound on the baseline, trailing by three. Top of the key is Cuyaba on the far side. Io. Now back to the baseline. Alexander cutting through, got it inside, looking for Gus Gunderson, and ball was knocked away out of bounds. It'll stay with the Cougars. That'll bring Jacob Brooks, a 6'5 junior, as you said, Madison, South Dakota.
I can't say I ever recalled watching him play in high school, but I'm sure he played against my hometown Bulldogs and the big battle of Bulldogs. But
here comes Oyet into the front court for Valley City State. Kicks it on the wing to Hebrink. Up top, Gotch to Rickert for three off the arc. Cuyaba clears off the rebound. He'll outlet it. Near side, Brooks will bring it across. Nope, pass up, and that's out of bounds. Yep, turnover. Back over to the Vikings. Sometimes the sideline can be that sixth defender.
Yeah, yep. Just like in football, you know, they say the 12th. Well, in basketball, here it is, the sixth. And helping out the Vikings right there.
Duke Carey, junior out of Colorado Springs. Now we'll handle the point here for VCSU, leading by three. As we approach the 13-minute mark here, first half. Paul McDonald, Brady Femling joining here on VCSUVikings.com, live on YouTube. From the bubble, top of the key, Gotch, 15 on the shot clock, over to Oyet for three, off the mark. High rebound, Cuyaba clears it off for the Cougars. On the far side, Gunderson back to Cuyaba, comes across the timeline, just off the left elbow. Goes back up top, Iob, near side. Wants to go up top, does, to Alexander. Quick pass, far corner, Cuyaba. Posting up inside, Gunderson. Cutting through was Alexander. Ball stripped and out of bounds. Nice play by Eddie Oyet, but it'll stay with the Cougars with 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, that was a really good cut there by Corbin Alexander, and good job by Oyet to, you know, put a stop to that one, as he was almost wide open.
Now the inbounds comes up top of the key. Thomas Tiernan. Another hometown product for the Morris Air Chicago Tigers. Here on the near wing, Gunnarsson for three. Good, as the shot clock was winding bound. Gus Gunnarsson ties it with a three ball. 11-11, 12-12 to go here in the first half. Here's Carey, spin move. On a baseline, step back, shot over Brooks, short. Rebound controlled by Alexander. Back the other way, the Cougars at the chance to take the lead. Now hounded there as he came across the timeline to Brooks. Brooks back up top, Alexander. Off the right elbow, far side, Gunderson. Baseline left. Circles back around to Tiernan. Tiernan goes up top of the key. Here's Alexander. Brooks, baseline right. Three, they're long, two, no. And Tiernan, or the rebound, Lyman.
Really good job there by Carey to close out on that one and the guy in the corner.
Yeah, we've got a Carey called against Eddie Oyet and the turnover. Lyman in that opening game against Northwestern came off the bench and led the team with 10 rebounds, and he's a big body. Not only tall, but he is wide.
Yeah, he's really filled out and just plays the position very well.
Jared Johnson back in for the Cougars. He's got the basketball in the backcourt, right on the logo, and out far side to Tiernan. Back up here near side, Gunderson. Inside, Johnson posting up now. And he double dribbled, or 3 seconds. You know, either way, it's an infraction.
One thing about Lyman, you know, you don't see a lot of big men like that in the game anymore. We had two of them last year with Kevin Schramm and Connor Ency, but, you know, Lyman's got some big shoes to fill, but I think he can do it.
Coming out of West Fargo, state champs a couple years ago. Down low, here's Lyman on kills. You talk about him, he's going to get the ball.
Yep.
Lyman
spoke
with the bucket.
Into existence.
Crossover Gunderson, he comes across the timeline. Ball tipped by Munson, but right in the hands of Gunderson. Hesitates, comes in, little teardrop inside, missed everything. And an offensive foul called on Gunderson.
I didn't even notice Hunter Sand slipped in there, and then all of a sudden he's taking a charge. Good job there to be just in the right position and stand there and take the charge.
But we have come to these parts to call that the Connor NC special. He was very
yes.
good at taking
yes,
the charge.
He was. I believe that's the second charge of the game now.
Yeah. Top of the key is Munson for the Vikings. They lead by two. Hebring to Carey. Back up top, Sand. 15 on the shot clock. Munson in the lane. Kicked it out. Ball knocked away by Blake Munson for the Cougars into the front court. Stops. Gives it off to the trailer. Johnson for two. Jared Johnson's first bucket for the for the Cougars. We're back tied at 13. Underneath was Lyman and traveled. Well, you may have got away with that in high school, but they watch it a little bit closer in college.
Yeah, yeah, the officiating just gets better and better. Vikings kind of changing up their looks a little bit here. They'll go from five out to a 4-1. So just a little bit of a rotation here.
Munson on the far side. Now gets it over there to Dak, to Munson. Far corner, Johnson. Skip pass to Dak. Three-pointer, just off the right wing, rolls off. Hunter Sand with the rebound. One thing I've noticed about Hunter Sand over the years, just works so hard.
Yes.
Fakes, dribble drive, all the way, and no.
It's really starting to pay off for him. I mean, we all saw the big game he had last year. That was just huge, earning him, I believe, he earned North Star Player of the Week after that week, and he's just come a long way since I've been watching him.
We've got immediate timeout. We'll step aside. 9:43 to go here in the first half. We're tied at 13. This is Viking basketball on VCSUVikings.com. Bob McDonald and Brady Femling back with you here. I'm pronouncing it right, Femling?
Yeah, yep.
Okay.
You're one of
the L is on the right spot.
Yes, yes. Everybody pronounces it Fleming, but not. You're spot on, though. You're getting the Femling.
All right. Here on the near side, Cougars with the basketball. To the free throw line, Johnson. Try to go down low. Ball knocked away by Carey. Diving on the floor. He and Carlin battle. And it's going to be, let's go to the review. Oh, that's right. They don't have that.
If only.
It looks like it'll be Cougar ball. Inbounds on the far side for Paul Dak. He'll bring it into Munson. Five on the shot clock. Carey box it away. Great defense here by the Vikings. Only four on the shot clock.
Yeah. That, you know, even though we didn't come up with the steal there, just poking that one away makes it so much tougher because now they got to reset and get a fresh shot. And like that, it wasn't a high-quality one like you would like to see.
Long three by Munson comes up long. Hebrink into the front court, stops, pop, shot, good.
He is so good from mid-range, just able to knock that down night in and night out.
Well, you want instant offense, just add Tate, averaging 16 points a game in the first two games this year. Here's the top of the key. Johnson long two. Doesn't go. Lyman with another board. Hebrink back into the front court for the Vikings. Leading by two. Goes up top of the key. Nice pass to the cutter. Munson missed it. Lyman there for the cleanup. Can't get it to go. And then Munson clears it off for the Cougars.
Yeah, that was a great cut there by Devontae Munson and found him in stride. Really would have liked to see the conversion on that one.
And then Bonte called for the reach-in. Kind of a frustration foul. He'll pick up his second. And it's a 15 foul on the Vikings. 15-13, VCSU over University of Minnesota Morris. 8.5 minutes to go, first half. Here from the bubble, Tiernan up top to Dak. Dak gets it off to Munson. Free at the line, Johnson. Johnson, one dribble, back up top to Dak. Far side, Munson on the wing. Pass into the lane to Johnson. Over to Tiernan, three-pointer from there, good.
Really good ball movement there by the Cougars, just able to find the open man, but Valley City's been making it tough for him all night.
Thomas Tiernan with the three ball. And it's a one-point lead for the Cougars. Here's Sand, and an offensive foul called. Maybe on Eddie? Yep, on Eddie Oyet.
I think it was.
Gotch, Rickard, and Schlotty. Matthew Schlotman making an appearance.
I tell you what, I student teach. Last year, I student taught with Matthew Schlotman a little bit. We did some observations, and standing next to him, you can tell he is the biggest player on the basketball team.
There's a lot of guy there, 6'9". Filled out a little bit, too, since he came in from Hastings as a freshman.
Yeah, yes, he has.
He's inside. He changed that shot. Hebring over to Gotch. Gotch, top of the key for the Vikings, trailing by one. Three-pointer, Oyet, and that misfires. And it's kicking down by the Cougars. Iob has it. In the backcourt, still. Now Munson across on the far side, comes across the timeline. Right-hand dribble. Pass here near side to Dak. Dak steps back, slide, crossover. Pass down low. Nice move by Johnson, and he missed the bunny and then got the foul. That'll be number one on Jarrett. He got behind Schlotman, the perfect entry pass, but I think he was too wide open.
Yeah, it's one of those things where it's almost too good to be true. You just can't believe it.
He's like, whoa, I'm open. And then he got a frustration foul after missing it after the rebound. Vikings down by one, 7 minutes remaining, first half. Into the front court, Rickard. Left-hand dribble near side. Left link into the corner. Hebring for three. Count it.
It's automatic when he is the last one that you should ever leave wide open, because that's like a free throw for him.
Five for Tate off the bench. And the Vikings back up by two. Cougars ball stripped by Rickard. Into the hands of Gotch. Now Duth lost the dribble. Picked up by Cuyaba. And the Cougars come back to the way. Dak, and a foul there called on Eddie Oyet. That's going to be number two on Eddie.
Yeah, I wonder if Coach Montgomery isn't going to find a sub for him here or let him play through it. Still pretty early in this one, 6:31.
Yeah. Jacob Brooks back in the lineup for the Cougars. At the line, Paul Dak, 6'3 junior out of Lincoln, Nebraska. Free throw up. Good. Another free throw to go. Oh, they were confirming that Eddie's got two fouls on him.
Yeah.
Second free throw is good. We are tied at 18. Hunter Sand back in.
You can tell a lot of this Cougar offense goes through Dak. Hey, Hunter. I believe he's their leading scorer right now. He is with five.
And we got a whistle and a foul there called on Paul Dak. He's got his second. So Hunter sent in. Oyet out. With 6:18 to go here in the first half. Well, we'll get you caught up on what's going on around VCSU Athletics at halftime. There's a three from the corner. Count it.
See if we can get you a little update.
Another three ball. And the Vikings lead 21-18. A little five-point run here by the Vikings to take this lead. Here's Dak in the lane. Near side, Gunderson. Dribble drive, baseline right. Cut off there by Sand. Hounded. Now kicks it back up top to Dak. 10 on the shot clock, and he travels.
That's just the result of a great double team, especially down and the two spots you don't want to be, you don't want to get double teamed down on the baseline. You don't want to get double teamed in the corner, and that's exactly where he got double teamed, was both the baseline and the corner. And, you know, that travel there is just a result. He had to make a tough pass, and then Dak had to go up and get it. Well, that's just a result, as it's, you know, everything's kind of off balance, and there's the travel.
Hebrink has the ball tipped into the hands of Gunderson, into the front court. Gunderson, Rickert knocks it away, picked up, pass underneath, double pump, and no on the shot by Cuyaba. But I think Hunter Sand's going to pick up his first personal. So that will send Jarrett Cuyaba to the free throw line.
The Cougars 5 of 6 tonight from the charity stripe.
Missed on the first one.
The Lady Cougars, I believe they got to the charity stripe 26 times in our first game tonight.
Wow. Second free throw, no. Brooks grabs the rebound. Ooh, we slid. Yeah, there we go. That pivot foot just kind of slid along the floor. That's a travel. Well, the Vikings get the ball back, leading by 3. Low scoring first half.
Yeah, compared to what we had last year,
yeah,
this is a completely different game.
Here's Rickert inside. Gotch, little baby hook, rolls off the rim, can't get it to fall. And Placide clears off the rebound for the Cougars. I don't think we've had a timeout other than the media timeout.
Yeah, I think you're right. I don't think we've had, yeah.
Placide in amongst 3 Vikings, and one of them's going to be called for the foul.
I'm going to call that one on the floor, though. That's the right call there. Don't give him the end one.
That's number 2 on Hunter. Good student section tonight. I'm sure some of the volleyballers will make their way over here from Gratian after they're done.
Yeah, kind of a split event tonight where,
yeah,
you know, I'm sure half and half. Or
free throw off the back iron, can't get it to fall. Hebrink with the rebound. Tate coming down for the Vikings. All the way through from the elbow, comes up a little bit short. Gotch couldn't come. Dak has it for the Cougars, and he's going to slow things down just a bit as he comes across the timeline. Now to Brooks. Free throw line. Far corner. Cuyaba for 3. Count it. And a foul. The dreaded 4-point play opportunity.
You don't see too many.
Oh, it was after the shot.
I think they got him with a flopping foul.
You did. They counted it. So the whistle, just the flop, something they're really trying to clean up, and it's a technical. So Tate Hebrink at the line for the Vikings to try to give him the lead back. Rims out the first one. He's too close.
Yeah.
He's at the 15 feet away. He's too close.
You got to back him up to about 18 or deeper. That's his range.
So the free throws don't go. Vikings will get the ball, though, with 4.5 minutes to go here in the first half. We're tied at 21. Thomas Tiernan back in the lineup for the Cougars. Left-hand dribble in the front court. Rickert, top of the key, backs up, pass near side, Schlottman. And now stepping out of bounds with those size 14s is Duth Gotch, and the ball will go back over to the Cougars. I'm only guessing, but they look about that.
I would say you're probably about right. I cannot imagine how hard it is to find, you know, with basketball, I'm sure all of them have their favorite pair of shoes. Well, to find it in their size,
yeah,
I don't think it can't be easy.
Here's Cuyaba for the Cougars across the timeline. On the near wing, picked up the dribble. Gets it off to Gunderson. Back to Cuyaba. Cuyaba just off the elbow, right side. Now it gets over far side to Placide. He'll kick it into the corner. Tiernan for 3. Back iron too hard. Foul underneath. That's going to go against Schlottman, I think. Yep, it's going to go against Matthew Schlottman. His first. So Carlin to the line will shoot 1-1. Or 2, pardon me. That is the 10th.
Yep.
Free throw? No. 5 of 8 from the free throw line right now for the Cougars.
Yeah, I mean, those are gimmies. You got to be able to knock down your free throws, and early in the season, you can understand that a little bit, though. I mean, a lot of teams struggle with that. It's late in the season where you do not want to miss free throws, and he goes 0-for-2 there.
Well, he just missed them both. We're still tied at 21 with 3:50 remaining in this first half. Here's Rickert from the elbow, far corner. Hebring's already got a couple of threes. Kicks it on the wing. Schlottman from 21. Count it.
Dang. Wow.
How do you defense a 6'9 guy going 25 feet away?
I mean, that's hard to game plan against. I mean, it's hard to guard alone, but, you know, to see that on film and just somebody with that kind of range, that is so tough.
Now that foul's called on Hebrink. That'll be his first, so we're going to go back to the way, and maybe this is the best thing, sending the Cougars to the free throw line. They're 5-for-9 right now in the first half. Gunderson, his first trip to the line.
There he knocks it down. The 11th foul of the half for the Vikings.
Yeah. So Gunderson gets them both, and he comes out. Munson will come back in. 24-23, Vikings by one. 3:36 remaining here in the first half.
As of 30 minutes ago, the volleyball team leads Mayville 2-1.
All right.
I think Mayville took the third set.
Far three for San, in and out. Tip comes down, taken down by Carlin briefly. Now Tiernan controls for the Cougars. Yeah, and those two teams played in Mayville and went five sets.
Yeah.
And I think the Vikings were up 2-1, and the Comets came back and won the last two. So we have a turnover on the Cougars. Ball goes back over to the Vikings with 3:09 remaining. They'll inbound it just to the left of the scorer's table.
You know, compared to last year, this is a very low-scoring affair.
Yeah,
holy cow.
It is. Here's Rickert. Gets a pick. Took Munson 20 minutes to get around Schlottman. Here's a three-pointer off the rim for Schlottman. Rebound. Munson has it for the Cougars. Starts up the floor. Stop. Oh, that should be over and back, but they didn't see it. The ball actually wasn't over and back, just his foot. Because I think the ball's got to go front court, back court. There's a travel again. Making that first move is Dak, and he turns it over. I believe that's the rule. The whole ball's got to go over. Not even if a foot does, it doesn't matter.
It's almost like hockey.
Yes.
The puck's got to cross first.
Here's Rickert on the near side. San to Gotch. No, but he's got free throws coming.
Kind of a little bit of a circus finish there as he almost in midair spun and tried to finish that one, but able to pick up the foul, and now he's got a couple of free throws coming his way.
Carlin picking up his second. So Duth Gotch to the line. He's got 2 points. First trip to the line tonight.
Vikings only 0 for 1 tonight. Only one free throw attempt so far.
That is 1 of 2. I think that's going to be a key for this team this year. If they can get to the free throw line, get some points with the clock stopped, be aggressive going to the hole and get those charity tosses and knock them down.
Well, and you know, every time they're able to go to the, get to the line, it gives them a little bit of a break with this constant press.
Here are the Cougars trailing by three. Far side, Dak. Dribble drive, left of the lane. Underneath, left alone was Carlin. He missed it. Another bunny missed, and Schlottman cleans it up.
Good defense there by Hunter Sand, just able to get tall on that one.
Here's Sand, splits to the defense. Little scoop shot, no, but he's going to get charity tosses. There's Hunter Sand again doing what he does, working hard. And Carlin just picked up his third. So Hunter Sand to the charity stripe again. And no. Still looking for those first points.
Just didn't want to give us the right bounce there. Didn't want to drop in.
Second free throw by the right-hander, good. 27-23, Vikings by four, just over 2 minutes remaining, first half. Cougars in the front court with Dak. Cross court, knocked away. Rickert nearly had it. Munson got it back. And then Gotch gets it at center court. Duth Gotch all the way in. His floater, no, and an offensive foul called on Duth.
And right there, he must have got set just in time to pick up that charge call.
The referees in the stands disagree with the call.
I mean, I go to school with all of them, and I can sarcastically guarantee you that they're right.
Yeah.
Because they all know a lot about
basketball. That is the first foul on Duth. Cross court here near side. Alexander back to Dak. Three-pointer, left wing, good. Paul Dak has got nine. Make that, nine with that three.
Yep.
Had to do quick math. That hurt.
Long day.
Exactly. Here's Gotch to the free throw line. He'll take the fadeaway from 15, air ball. Schlottman cleans it up. Back to Hebrink. 10 on the shot clock. And then Tate draws a foul.
Good hustle there by Schlottman to go track that one down. Get it to your scorer, Tate Hebrink.
That is going to be the third on Paul Dak. So two starters right now for UMM with three fouls.
Well, and getting Paul Dak into foul trouble really hurts the Cougars because he's their leading scorer right now with nine.
Here's Hebrink at the line. Free throw, no. Rebound, Cougars. Minute 10 to go. 27-26, Vikings by one. Here's Munson on the wing. Far side, dribble drive. Ayub back up to Munson. Free throw line, Johnson, turn around, 15-footer, comes up short. Sand may have got a fingertip on it. Schlottman outlet to Hebrink. Tate hesitates, dribbling in, dumps it off, and a foul on the dribble drive. But it will send Hebrink to the line for the 1-1. Derek Ayub first.
Good job there by Tate. You know, if that wasn't on the ground, that's a guaranteed layup for Hunter Sand. Tate is very good at creating space for himself and finding shots. And alongside that, he's very good at finding the open man.
But again, missed free throw. Hebrink is 0 for 3 at the charity stripe now. On the far side, Brooks, top of the key, Johnson. Here to the near side, Alexander. Gets it over, three-pointer, Ayub can't go. Schlottman with the rebound. Here's Rickard, far side. Shot clock, game clock are exact even, but now a turnover as Rickard on that far sideline saying he was out of bounds. And we got a timeout taken by Coach Paul Grove and UMM. 26.6 seconds to go in the half. Cougars trailing Valley City State 27-26. Back with more Viking basketball on VCSUVikings.com.
You know, looking ahead to this weekend, VCSU both men's and women's basketball will travel to South Dakota to the Sanford Pentagon this weekend for the NAIA Classic. Live stats will be available for all games and live video will be available on pay-per-view. Viking volleyball is at home this Friday for the regular season finale. Come cheer on the Vikings against Presentation College on Friday at 6 p.m. in Gratian Gymnasium. Join us for Senior Day at Viking Football this Saturday, November 5th. Tailgating begins at 11 a.m. and kickoff against Presentation College is at 1 p.m. at Watkins Stadium. So come out and support the seniors in their last home game.
Cougars with the basketball, trailing by one. Here's underneath, reverse layup, Brooks is good. Now the Vikings can go last shot, down by one. Rickard across the timeline, left-hand dribble, now to the right hand. Rickard, top of the key, starts all the way through the lane, draws contact, he'll get two. Heads up play there by the sophomore, Caden Rickard.
Yeah, they just gave him the open lane, and why wait to take a buzzer beater when they're gonna give you that? Gotta convert here, though. Struggled from the line tonight.
Caden's first trip to the line. He's got 5 points. There we go. Saw him his senior year in high school. Caden Rickard for North playing against the Valley City Highliners. Had six steals that led to baskets in the first 3 minutes of the game.
Yeah, that not a very common stat. That's pretty unheard of. And
the best part, Coach Montgomery and assistant coach at the time, Carl Sorby, were in the audience recruiting.
Well, glad to have him here so we can do it here.
Here's a heave-ho at the horn, off the glass. Corbin Alexander says a prayer and gets it answered with a three-pointer as the horn sounds. So the Cougars lead 31-29 at the half.
Two games remaining, and then Mayville but it's not your traditional away game. We're headed to Fargo. They're going to play that one in the Fargo Dome. So a little bit of exciting news that got announced today, actually.
Well, we've got second half basketball here. The Vikings and the Cougars, 31-29. And we mentioned a couple of times in the first half, a far cry from the 123-61 game we saw last year.
Yeah, a little bit of a slower start for both teams, but I expect things to get rolling. Pretty high-scoring offense here in the second half.
Here on the near side, dribble drive, Dak in the lane, Carlin, layup good.
Back out for VCSU is your starting five with Rickard, Owens, Gotch, Munson, that is Devontae Munson, and Eddie Oyet.
And we've got a travel called again. I think that is the third traveling call against Paul Dak so far tonight.
Yeah, no, you're 100% right. That is his third. And, you know, that's not something you really see often from a team's leading scorer.
Here's Owen, top of the key. Spent some time on the bench in the first half because of two fouls at the free throw line. Oyet to Munson. Devontae. I don't know if that was tipped or knocked away or tried to behind the back. Into the hands of Munson. Alley-oop. Dak grabs it. Layup. And good. Oh, 4-0 start here for the Cougars. Not something the Vikings wanted to come out of the locker room and see.
That time just beating them back into transition. Blake's got to get back a little bit.
Here comes Munson. Dribble drive. Goes up. Off the glass. No. Foul called. He'll get two. Corbin Alexander will pick up his first. Well, this is where both teams got to clean things up. Vikings 5 of 9. At the charity stripe in that first half. Mrs. Munson's first trip. Good on the first. There we go.
Start the second half on a positive note. Just throw that first half out the window.
35-30. Second free throw. Count it. Munson gets to both. Yeah, near steal by Dodge, but picked up by Munson underneath. Layup good.
Really right there. I mean, tightening up the pressure on the press, where that was more of a trap, whereas before they're just kind of guarding, looking to steal. But that time they trapped him on the baseline and able to come up with the steal there, and Munson with the finish.
And then Paul Grove, coach of the Cougars, calls a timeout. And he immediately got in the ear of Ian Carlin. And so the turnover, the Vikings now quickly back within two after UMM scored the first 5 points of the second half.
All right, Paul, so I got to ask. I know you're familiar with the Morris area, or more UMM Cougars. Are Paul and Tim Grove brothers?
They are.
They are, okay. Because I saw Tim was the head coach for the women's basketball, and now Paul for the men, so I just assumed,
yep,
but wanted to make sure I was correct.
And they both are associate athletic directors for UMM out of the Long Prairie Gray Eagle area is where they're from originally. Here's a three-pointer by Munson. Good.
The California native.
And also
hits his
Paul
second.
Coached his son Josh, or his nephew Josh, at UMM as well. In the lane, Rickard, turnaround, teardrop, good.
Really good dribble move there by Caden Rickard just to give himself a little bit of space, create that separation, and have a better chance of knocking down the jumper.
Right now the Vikings need a stop, trailing 38-35. As Tate Hebrink will check into the lineup here for the Vikings. And Cougar basketball, 18-15 to go here in the second half. Munson in the backcourt, watched by Gotch to Dak. Dak to the middle, Johnson on the far side, Alexander on the wing, back up top to Munson. Munson hip on, dribble here to the near side, Dak. Dak back to Munson. Just off the elbow, gives it over, Johnson, three-pointer from the wing, good. Jarrett Johnson knocks down the triple. 6-point lead for the Cougars.
Yeah, they're starting to get hot from behind the arc.
Here's the foul going to be called on Munson.
They're going to get him with body. That one's going to stay on the floor. Blocking foul.
And that'll be his first. T. 10-6 here in the second half so far. Cougars have opened up this six-point lead, their biggest of the game. Rickard circling around, right of the lane, all the way to the hole for two.
He is just so quick and has such a tight handle on the ball, able to just dribble through traffic like that. Very impressive.
And, of course, he's got the ability, if he can or needs to kick it out, and that's why sometimes defenses collapse on him and forget that he can take it to the hole as well. Here's a long three by Munson. Good.
And Munson's starting to heat up now from behind the arc. He's two or three of six now. So back to 50% for him.
44-37. Both teams already shooting better to start the second half than they did the first half. Here's Gotch. Right of the lane. Ball knocked away by Alexander. Gotch gets it back. Turnaround shot. Good.
You know, the thing about Duth is he is just so long that it's just, you know, a shot like that for me, who I'm 6 foot, that's still a not easy shot. But, like, for a guy like Duth, he's just so long, able to just slip that one in.
Here's Johnson, far corner, Dak to Alexander, back to Munson. 14 on the shot clock. Alexander, baseline, Johnson right side, lost it, got it back, kicked it off. Munson, three-pointer, left corner, good. Back-to-back threes by Blake Munson.
The Viking defense might have to go grab that fire extinguisher over in the corner because he's on fire right now.
And we got a 30-second timeout taken by Valley City State with 16:09 left to go here in this second half. 47-39, Cougars with the lead.
All of us from VCSU Athletics, including myself, would like to thank the Century Club for its continued support and financial contributions that go directly to our student athletes like me. To join, talk to a Century Club member or call 845-7161.
Yeah, you mentioned the weather on Saturday is not going to be conducive. Well, tailgating's always fun regardless of what the weather is going to be like. But come on out, senior day for the Vikings. Definitely a disappointing season for the Viking football team. Here's Rickard to Hebrink. He's stepped out of bounds right in front of his coach. You don't want to do that.
No, absolutely not.
So it'll be Cougar basketball. Cougars leading by eight, 47-39. We have about 4 minutes gone here in the second half. Top of the key, Dak between the rings, left-hand dribble. Left of the lane, cut off by Owens, and a foul on Joseph. That's number three.
He just cannot catch a break tonight. He's picking up just little ones like that. I believe that's his third now, right? Because he picked up two early on, yeah. And then... I don't think he came back in the second half.
Not as of now. Here's a long three-pointer. Munson misfires on that one. Rebound controlled by the Cougars. Placide. He kicks it off to Johnson. Johnson, three-pointer from the wing, off the mark. And Rickard has it. Here come the Vikings, trailing by eight. Rickard, far side, Hebring. Dribble drive, baseline left, shot up, good.
You know, the thing about Hebring's jump shot is he just hangs in the air for so long and really just kind of allows himself time to it's almost like it's a timing thing with the defender, and he's able to almost be more open just because of how long he's in the air for.
Johnson's three doesn't go. Oh, yeah, rebounds Rickard. Vikings trail by six. Three-pointer Hebring almost cut it in half. Alexander grabs the board for UMM. Back to Dak. Dak into the front court. Traveled or a charge. Charge.
That's Rickard's second one he's taken tonight, and I think that one hurt a little bit, but good job there to stay in the paint, just take the charge.
And that's four fouls on Dak.
Yeah, I don't know how much we're going to see of him now going forward. I think he's going to have to sit a little bit till we get later on into this one.
So the Vikings will have the ball back, trailing by six, 47-41. Okay, they get the turnover, but they need to convert these turnovers.
Yeah, that's the biggest, you know, second chance points off of offensive rebounds. and scoring off of turnovers. If you can do both of those things very well, you're going to win a lot of basketball games.
Hebring, far side, Rickard. Top of the key, Oyet, back to Gotch. Gotch, 8 on the shot clock. Corner to Hebring. Hebring, dribble drive. 4 on the shot clock. Gotch, fade away from 12. Shot blocked. Cougar rebound, foul called on Tate Hebring. That'll be his second. And that will bring Hunter Sand in, and Hebring, no, Gotch will sit down.
Each team now with 3 fouls. I see Thomas Tiernan coming in.
Last time I saw him, he was a 6th grader.
Holy cow. What is he now, freshman?
And I think his hair was about that long, too, then. Yes, he is a freshman now. Actually, probably would have been a 7th grader. Here comes Munson into the front court. All the way through. High block there by Owens. Get it out of here. Not in my town. Joseph Owens, just that's what you call a rejection.
Yeah, able to go up and just swat that one. Not even a block, an absolute swat.
Inbounds, far side. And Ayub brings it in. Grabbed by Placide. Placide stripped by Sand. Ball on the floor. And we're going to get a jump ball or a timeout. Nope. Cougar, it's a Viking basketball on the alternate possession. Great hustle there by Hunter Sand to create that turnover.
Yeah, good job there. Just poke that one out and then stay with it. Don't give up on it and diving on the floor. Getting the jump ball and getting the ball back to the Vikings.
Gus Gunderson will check back in for the Cougars. 47-41, UMM leading, 14:06 to go here in the second half. Rickert will bring it across the Viking logo. Starts in off the pick here on the near wing. Top of the key, Sand, far side. Oyet for 3, short. Rebound, Owen had it, and it was knocked away. And out of bounds, it'll stay with the Vikings. So VCSU will maintain possession. Rickert to Hebring. Reverse layup. Good.
Oh, my goodness. Acrobatic finish at the rim there by Tate Hebring. That is so – I can't believe that. His scoring ability has come so far over just the last year, and we're seeing in these first 3 games. Wow.
Hebring now with a dozen. Came in averaging 16 off the bench. On the far side, Rickert knocks it away, and then it went off Gunderson. It'll be Viking basketball.
A little bit of momentum now starting to go VCSU's way. Starting to claw their way back into this one as they now only trail by 4.
Rickert now for the Vikings in the front court, down by 4. 13-12 remaining. Starting in, he'll take the little teardrop just to the right of the lane for 2.
Good pick there set by Hunter Sand. Able to just completely get the defender off of Rickert.
Pressure, Rickert knocks it away, out of bounds. It will stay with the Cougars.
You know, one thing to watch here, though, they've got 2 seconds to get the ball down the court because there's 22 left on the shot clock, so they're going to have a short shot clock to begin with, but they've got to get this so they don't get the 10-second violation.
Yep. Paul Grove having a discussion with the official, and the Cougars want to take a timeout. 12:57 left to go. This is a full timeout taken by UMM. Vikings trailing 47-45. It'll be Cougar basketball when we return. Viking hoops from the bubble on the VCSUVikings.com.
Yeah. Paul McDonald, Brady Femling back with you here at the bubble. W. Osmond Fieldhouse, Valley City State, and University of Minnesota Morris. The Viking women winning 61-58, I believe, was,
yep,
the,
yep.
was the final, and a barn burner in the first game.
That's Viking
and there's
basketball.
A turnover.
Wow. Good hustle play right there by Caden Rickard. And I don't think he gets the steal stat for that, but
yeah,
more of a hustle stat there.
So the inbounds now for Rickard. Chance to tie or take the lead. Here's Hebring. Stop, elbow left, shot, no. Halfway down, comes out. Rebound, far side, controlled by the Cougars. Here's Gunderson. Gunderson brings it across. All the way down, pass underneath, and the ball knocked away. Offensive foul. Tate Hebring will take that charge. You know, I think that's a stat that does some coaches keep, but you don't see it in an official box score, and that's charges taken.
Yeah. No, you not in the box score, but, I mean, I know when we played high school basketball, our coach would give a Gatorade for every charge that you took, and there were some guys that would have, like, four or five Gatorades the next day at practice just because they would sit in the paint and take charges all game long, and it forces turnovers.
Here's Rickard. After he shimmy and shakes, takes a 15-footer. Can't get it to go. Johnson controls for the Cougars. They lead by two, 12-22 to go for second half. Gunderson across the timeline to Johnson near side. Jarrett directing traffic. Hands it off. Ayub on the wing. Pass off of the fingertips of Johnson and another turnover. Johnson, a senior on this team for the Cougars, trying to help some of the younger guys there. After the play, kind of tell them what should have happened.
Where he should have put that ball.
Yeah. On the near side, Hebring. Driving through, left hand, no foul. And before the shot.
Oh, they're going to go on the floor, you're saying.
So it was before the shot. Foul going to be called on Gunderson, his first, or his third, pardon me. And Rickard brings it into Owens. And he traveled. Coach Montgomery looked at assistant coach Wagner and said, did he? And Tim, yeah.
Yeah.
They tried to go with that little juke step, and sometimes they drag that pivot put or take a little extra step. Here's Gunderson in the backcourt for the Cougars. They lead by two. After a flurry of scoring to start the half, it's kind of settled down here the last couple of minutes.
I feel like both teams have just came out with a lot more intensity here in the second half. Great steal there by Joseph Owens.
Into the front court and then had the ball knocked away, and it's picked up by Dak. Didn't take care of the ball, and now the Cougars come back the other way.
The big man tried taking it coast to coast.
On the wing, Dak up top. Carlin to Tiernan. Tiernan picks up the dribble top of the key. Far side, Gunderson driving through. Left-hand layup, no. Foul call.
That one going to go against.
So that foul is going to be called on Rickard.
Rickard.
And that is his first.
I didn't know if they said 1-2 or just 2.
Yeah, that's what I, because I thought he said Tate Hebring, but the scoreboard says number 2, and number 2 is at the line, and Gus Gunderson. And he hits the first.
The Rickard-Hebring combo's really been something tonight. As combined, they've scored 25. Rickard's got 13, and Hebring's got 12.
Gunderson gets them both. 49-45. As the Cougars lead by four. Rickard, top of the key, lineman to Hebring. Oyet, dribble drive. Oyet, ball comes out of his hands. Ball picked up by Alexander. And the Cougars back the other way. Hands it off, Gunderson. Top of the key. Near side, Carlin. Just off the wing. 15 on the shot clock, Dak. Off the elbow, far side, Alexander. Dribbling through, runs over Rickert, and there's number four for Caden Rickert.
Wow. That is crazy. I mean, is he getting a stat for it? No, but that's four turnovers that he's caused just off of charges. And not even to keep in mind the steals that he has tonight. I believe he's got one or two.
So the Vikings, again, a chance here. They get the ball back. Munson, Rickert, top of the key. Here on the near side, Hebring. Tate to the free throw line, traveled, no call. Munson up top, near side. Sand for three, count it.
You cannot leave him wide open from beyond the three-point line. It's like a free throw for him, it's automatic.
49-48. Been about 5 minutes since the Vikings had a field goal, and now a foul on Caden. I got him for two. And that is the fourth 15 foul on the Vikings.
So the start of the fourth quarter, if you want to say, with 9:58 remaining as we're halfway through the second half. And we got a tight one.
Yeah, we go. 49-48. Inbounds, far side, Alexander. Brings it in to Johnson. Jarrett hands it off to Dak. Watch there by Sand. Dak gives it to Johnson. Hands it off, Alexander. Left elbow, back door, Dak layup good. Paul Dak with the easy bucket off the nice backdoor pass by Alexander. Lead back to three for UMM.
And I wonder if that one's built into their offense or if Dak just did that on his own.
Lyman with the putback.
And there it is. There's that second chance bucket that the Vikings really missed in that first half. Is Lyman able to go up and get the offensive rebound and then convert?
51-50. Dak baseline caught up by Lyman. On the wing, Alexander. Top of the key to Johnson. Back to Munson, 15 on the shot clock. Blake Munson up top,